dump on his parents.
Okay, look alive. We're now looking at Aunt Bertha. Hello there, Auntie.
Hey, you heard about him?
Alf. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, Alf, come on. Have you ever seen that?
Alf.
What's that, brother?
Alf. Have you ever seen Alf?
Yeah, Alf. That's funny, isn't it?
You seen him come on?
Jojo, give Grandma her gift.
You bring me my gift.
Yeah. Julia.
Yeah, I threw Alf. Look at this place we are.
Which one is it?
The red grand.
$30
worth of pictures and only sent her a little
wall
size.
What? That's all he sent you?
Yeah, but I don't. That's a graduation from prom. No.
Istanbul.
Oh, let me see. I haven't seen your prom
picture. It's not my prom.
I mean, me go.
Thank you.
Isn't she pretty? Now, you should have had sense to have a shake like this. Wow. Well, you should have rolled off the red carpet.
A wrestler in this thing.
A
wrestler. All right, this is Channel 3 News. Today we have Kids World.
Put it on TV.
And this is Kids World. We need a spokesman for Kids World. Today we have the kids of the Fogg family. Who's going to be the spokesman?
Okay, now y'all got to back up a little bit.
Stay on the steps.
Okay, now, let me first, I want each kid to step up and tell me your names. The young lady in the checkered dress, what is your name?
Fanta Barnes.
Fanta Barnes.
And you have a name too.
You gotta give me your name and you gotta give me your age.
My name is Fanta Barnes and I'm 10 years old.
Did you forget your age?
She said 10.
Yes, she had to think about it. Okay, here's one for you. What grade are you in, Fanta?
4.
Is that right? And what are you inspiring to be in the future?
Artist and a clothing designer.
Nope, we must have Fanta to say it.
I'm going to be an artist and a clothing designer
when I grow up. Wee donkey! And ladies and gentlemen, that is Fanta Barnes. That is my oldest sister, Sylvia Fogg's daughter, and her husband, Clarence Barnes, his daughter. Next one is the young lady that I'm now showing. What is your name, young lady?
Who? Which one?
That's you.
No, my name is Tamika Barnes, and I'm 8 years old.
You're 8 years old?
Yes.
And what are you aspiring to be when you grow up?
A singer.
A singer?
And yes. A teacher.
Okay, well now, wait a minute. You're aspiring to be a singer, then you're going to have to give us a tune.
Let me get back.
Wait a minute, who's this? Well, you look like King Kong. All right, look. I'm sorry, that was Mighty Joe Young just stepped in the way. Okay, now, can you sing a little song for us?
Sing
that song right there.
Sing
James. All right, do you know, let's see, I'll tell you, here's one you can sing. No, sing this one. Sing, come and stroll down Blessed Boulevard.
Come over here.
What do you know? Can you sing? It's a wonderful day in the neighborhood. Okay, we're going to the next young lady.
She's the right thing.
Okay.
Oh.
Is it my cousin?
Oh, that sounds good. Keep going, keep going.
Will you let her sing?
We don't. No, I'm sorry. That sounds so nice. Keep going. Keep going. All right. Okay, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Miss Tomika Barnes on Kids World. Okay, now we're going to this young lady here sitting in the middle, looking down at a little doll baby. And young lady, what is your name?
Tiffany
Wee doggy. And how old are you, young lady?
I'm 11 years old and I'm in the sixth grade.
Well, right on. Okay. And what are you inspiring to be?
Pediatrician or obstetrician.
Is that right? Now, don't you have a sister that wants to be that too?
She wants to be a pediatrician.
No, she wants to be.
Do you find that a conflict?
No.
You don't? Woo. And let me ask you this. When do you think this is going to happen?
Long time. I'm gonna be a doctor though.
This is, by the way, those who are listening in, this is Tomika Fogg. I'm sorry. Ooh-wee. This is... Okay. This is... Hey, who's putting their little fingers in the way? This is Arnold and Deborah Fogg's daughter, the youngest of three.
Whoops.
I mean, the second youngest of four.
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm not four.
And she's going to be a doctor of kids. Okay, now, where's the next one? Right here. Young lady? What is your name?
Elia Dawn Johnson.
Woo, doggy. Okay. And what are you inspiring to be when you grow up? You gotta look into the camera, Laya.
She forgot the
a skater.
A skater? What are you gonna skate? What kind of skate? Don't kiss that, Laya, because it might be dirty. Come on around so I can see you. You're hiding behind the bars. All right, so now, what kind of skate are you gonna be skating? What kind of skate, Laya? Roller skate, ice skate?
Ice skate.
Ice skate? Okay. And, how old are you?
Five.
You're five? I can't see you. You're hiding behind the bars. Come on out.
Five.
You're 5 years old? And what grade are you in?
Five.
Are you in
here? Huh?
I'm not in a grade.
What are you in?
Kindergarten, preschool.
Preschool?
Huh?
Sing
school. What is it?
Montessori school.
Oh, okay. Okay, Vanessa. This is Kids World.
Montessori school.
Okay, and what kind of school is that? Is that a private school?
Private school, I don't know.
Okay. And who's your mother and father?
Forrest Digger Johnson Jr. and Mary Fogg Johnson.
Okay. Alrighty, and do you have any brothers or sisters?
No brothers. I have no brothers, but I have a sister, and it's in the door. Oh, Marvin, that's your name.
Okay. Now, we got here a little fella here. Little fella, what is your name?
Zarin Fogg.
Zarin Fogg? Is that right? And Zarin? How old are you, Zarin?
Four years old.
What is that?
Four years old.
You're 3 years old?
No.
Four.
Four? Okay, don't get in the camera, y'all. I can't talk. I can't see. Okay, now. Zarin, Eli, come on. Zarin, back up a little bit. Okay, now listen. Hey, listen. How old are you? 4 years old? And what grade are you in? Huh?
You got Jolly Red.
What is it?
One.
Is that right?
She's in the fourth
grade. And what is your father's name?
Julius.
What's his last name?
Julius Fogg.
Oh, hey, man, that's all right.
What about my mommy?
What about your mother's name?
Richard Fogg.
Okay. And what do you want to be when you grow up?
What about my brother?
Wait a minute, what are you going to be when you grow up?
A fireman.
A fireman? That's where fires are. You like fires? Why do you like fires? Come on, y'all, I can't hear him. I'm questioning him. Why do you like fires?
It's an adventure.
Wait. Hey, look, slow down, y'all. Come on. Wait, time out. How did you eat fire? It didn't burn your tongue? Not even your lips?
Not even your mouth.
Huh?
Not even your mouth.
Okay. Yeah, they're on TV. Jazz. Yeah, this is Kids World. So let me ask you this. So that's why you want to be a fireman? Okay. Well, it's better to be. I'm getting ready to do you, brother. Remember something. It's better to be a fireman than a firebug. Remember that. As long as you don't want to be a firebug, that's cool. Okay. We're going to the next one. Okay, we have a gentleman sitting here on the edge. He's wearing a blue shirt with some checkered pants. With some multicolored shorts.
Summer pants.
And summer pants, his brother says. And what is your name, sir?
That's Nemo Green Snake.
What is your name?
London Fogg.
London Fogg. Hey, somebody's hair's in the background.
Can I get by, sir? Thank you.
Eli, you're in the way there, buddy. Little girl. Okay. All right, now look, London, what would you like to be?
I would like to be roller skate a lot and go ice skating a lot. I would like to be an ice
cabane. Aliyah, you're in the way.
I would like to be in the ice cabane in a comedy show.
You like to be in the what?
In the comedy show in the ice cabane.
Is that right? Oh, well, far out, man. Is that right? Okay, so you want to be a comedian? Is that right?
No. I want to be in the ice capades and make kids laugh.
You want to make kids laugh? You want to be a clown?
No.
A clown? Look, wait a minute. They got clowns on skates.
I know that.
Okay. All right. What would you like to, where do you want to go to school? Or where do you go to school at?
Capital Christian Academy.
And what grade are you in?
Third.
And how old are you?
Eight.
8 years old. Okay, good.
Two third grade and
okay.
Two
and do you have any inspirations to play any type of sports, anything?
Soccer.
Soccer? Okay. That sounds pretty good. All right. Well, now, so we've just spoken to London Fogg, whose little brother just gave us an interview just now. And his name is Zarin Fogg. Okay, we're going to the little fellow that's sitting right behind him there. He's grinning now. If London, London, you're in the way there. I can't see him, London. Have that little fella to look this way.
He has very oversized teeth.
Sir? Hey, sir. Sir? No, London, don't do that to him. What is your name, young man? I'm waiting. Look at me. Come on. You can do it. Your name is Nicholas? Okay, Nicholas, how old are you?
Six.
You 6 years old? Oh, wow, I didn't know that. Okay, what grade are you in, Nick? First grade?
Yes.
Okay, what's your last name?
Fogg.
Fogg? Okay, and what do you want to do when you grow up?
I don't know.
Now, you got to tell me something.
I want to play football.
You want to play football?
No, basketball.
You want to play basketball? Why you like basketball over football?
Because.
Huh?
I football.
Yeah, but which one do you like the best? You like, no, you. I think you like basketball better.
She's making me say it.
No, well, you say what, say, No, you say it. You know, go ahead. Huh? I'm watching Tiffany. I got my other eye on her. Okay, let me ask you this. You want to play basketball?
Yeah.
You think you're going to be tall enough? Huh? How do you know? You're kind of short now, buddy. What makes you think you're going to get any taller than you are? Huh? You think you're going to get taller? Huh? How do you know you're going to get taller? Huh?
I grow.
There you go. That's right. You grow. That's right. Okay, little buddy. Thanks for the interview. And ladies and gentlemen, I think we've just about summed up Kids World. We've interviewed everybody.
Do it again.
All of the kids here. So now what I want y'all to do is bunch up in a little group here. No, y'all gotta back up a little bit. Y'all gotta back up a little bit.
Hi, Lauren. Hi, Lauren.
And this is Lauren. Lauren is looking in the window, and she's smiling. Hi there, Lauren. And what do you want to do when you grow up? What do you want to do when you grow up? Lauren, how old are you? Huh? How old are you? You know how old you are? Hey, I'm interviewing her, Arnold.
Hi, Lauren.
Say hi to Matthew.
Hi, Matthew.
Arnold, I was interviewing her.
Hi, Matthew.
Hey there.
Hi, Matthew.
Hi there, Lauren. Lauren, what do you want to do when you grow up? Lauren, what do you want to do when you grow up?
Say she want to get down. Get down.
Wow. That right there, that's Mighty Joe Young.
I'm his father.
He's a bad man. Yeah, Otto, yeah, you look just like a cat in the window. And this here is a picture.
You got the lens on.
Did you touch it?
Happy
birthday.
No, I
can't. No, that's
what I was
saying.
See the look on his face.
How'd they
get away?
And Erica? Because that is Erica Fogg. Erica, this is the daughter of one of the brothers. And what are you aspiring to be when you grow up?
I'm planning to be a pediatrician.
Is that correct? Okay, that's when you grow up or now?
When I grow up.
Woo doggy.
I'm 17 years old.
17, wow.
No.
She's been around for 17 years. Can you believe it? Okay.
Let me see it. I can't.
Erica? Where do you plan on going to school at?
Maryland University.
And she's very tall. How tall are you?
I'm 5'7".
5'7"?
Yeah.
And how old are you?
17. 17?
Is that still in a, is that still 17? That's right below 18, is that correct? Let me ask you this. Where you plan on going to school then?
I have an interview.
Tom, you gonna split, man? We got Thomas Davis Jr. here. I grew up with the guy, so I know him. Thomas, what do you plan on doing when you grow up?
Still work with the mob?
You want to be a monk? what kind of work do you do there, brother?
I fix radios.
Give us that title again. No, we want the title, brother. The photographic specialist.
We want the big title. I fix TVs and radios.
This is Thomas Davis Jr. He's born in December. He's an information specialist with photographs and works at DIS and is planning on moving on into the FBI and the CIA and look at all the rest of it. On Fogg on tape.
Yeah.
And Mr. Fogg.
That's yours.
Hey, Tommy, you gone? Hey, Tommy.
You got her number?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Thank you.
Probably get her in the car now.
Oh,
you
have
a car phone? Yeah.
Always be ready. Okay, and right here we have We have Arnold. We have Arnold and
Joe Don Sepp.
Did Lauren, did somebody take her?
We're now interviewing Arnold Fogg and Deborah Fogg. This is Face the Nation. And they can't seem to adjust themselves. Apparently they're hot and they're sweating. Arnold's not sure, and he's scratching his neck.
Did you find him?
Well, let me ask you this, brother.
Can you
Lauren?
Yeah.
Now, how long have y'all been? This is Arnold Fogg and Deborah Fogg.
Is it locked?
No. Maiden name Deborah Ford. Maiden name Arnold Mighty Joe Young. And okay, my question is, how long have you been married? This is the Jim Baker out. All right, my question is, how long have you been married?
Well, according to official documents, it's been approximately about 18 years. They're close, about somewhere in that proximity.
Is that right?
18 years.
18 years. Wee doggy. Okay, let me ask you this. How long have you known each other?
Since birth?
I was conceived
in this house. It was planned.
Is that right?
My parents planned with my parents.
It's that? Okay.
Unofficial reports will accent that she approximately was conceived in this house. However, I'm a little doubtful of that this time.
Weird doggy.
Just okay. As soon as I get further information, we will be contacting you to let you know.
Okay, let me say this. All right, that's good. Okay, now what do you do as far as your employment status?
I'm a self-employed merc.
The boy's a bounty hunter.
A mercenary.
And let's see, Mrs. Fogg?
I please the family.
Weird doggy.
She's what is known as the employed family pleaser.
Is that right? The family pleaser.
Yes.
Okay.
Entertainer. Mother.
Yes. I'm zooming in on that. Go ahead.
On the entertainer part.
The entertainer.
Microwave.
Man, this camera, I don't know if it's my eyes or like it's blurry. Okay. Now, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. You have Brother Arnold Fogg and Debbie Fogg. They both sing on a choir at church.
Oh, my God.
And they go to the attendant way at Cross Church. They live out in, what's that area you live in?
We live in Cantown.
Is that right?
Fort Washington area.
In Fort Washington area. They both are Washingtonians, born and reared right here in this home. Okay. Now we're going to be going over to Grandma. Grandma Pearl, how you doing today?
Fine.
Okay, she's up from Roanoke area, that's Bassett, Virginia. And she's been around quite a while. And this is Mom's mom. This is my mother's mother. And Pearl, how do you like being here? Okay, that's good. And that's her grandniece, daughter. That's little Lauren there. And what are you doing there, Lauren?
Okay.
And this is Sylvia. Sylvia, how you doing?
I'm fine.
Okay, and what is your last name?
Barnes.
Okay, that's good. What's your maiden name?
Fogg.
Oh, okay then. Do you have any kids?
Three.
Okay, and what are their names?
Jamar, Fanta, and Tamigo.
Make sure you get it right now.
Yeah.
Okay.
Jamar, Fanta, and Tamigo.
Okay. And, well, that's good.
And she was born and raised here.
With each one of the kids.
Oh, all right.
Okay. But how many, now that I'm back, how many kids do you have there, brother?
Jeff, you
take.
Four
children.
Come on.
Erica, 17. Joseph, the second, 16.
children.
Tiffany would take that 11 and Nicholas 6.
And now, okay, now what are they aspiring to be? JoJo says he wants to be a ballet dancer. What about the rest of them?
Erica will start Maryland University in the fall.
She didn't call you.
And she wants to become a pediatrician.
Okay.
Tiffany also wants to be a pediatrician.
Is that right? And what is a pediatrician?
No, Tiffany wants to be an obstetrician.
Obstetrician?
Obstetrician?
Okay. Pediatrician.
She wants to deliver the baby. Erica wants to take care of the baby. JoJo wants to become an attorney.
No, yeah, I have not yet decided on my future career.
Is that right?
That is correct.
Okay, you've not yet decided? Okay. These are the twins, Julius and Judy.
Oh, you have to go in Vanessa's room to play house.
she has a bigger role.
Hi.
So you want a private interview, huh?
Have you all had dinner already?
I don't want to get the address. Y'all want my home for a private interview.
A private interval? Okay. Okay. Well, this bad boy will see the pimples on your face, and you can bring this right up close. Okay, look, why don't y'all sing a song?
Oh, I wasn't finished.
Come and stroll down Blessed Boulevard. Hey, somebody's in the way. All your problems, they will soon be solved. Come on, let's sing. He will set your mind at ease. He'll set you free. Come and stroll down Blessed Boulevard.
Come and stroll
down Blessed Boulevard. All your problems, they will soon be solved. You'll set your mind you free. Come and stroll down Blessed Boulevard. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. And that's Aunt Bertha. Auntie, I have a question for you.
Nobody here plays the piano. Just me.
8 years? Wow, it's been 8 years since I've been on the job.
Hey,
Aunt Bertha, let me ask you this. How do you like it in here?
Nick?
Is that right?
Walk.
Okay, that's good.
House, not outside.
And how do you like your family?
Nicholas?
Is that right?
Why don't you go and run it? You understand me?
Stay on the side. Why don't you go to the backyard?
Okay. That's good. Okay, let me, hey, Sonny. Brother Fogg. Zolly? Now we have here, this is Zolly Fogg, the eldest of the kids, the sons of Katie Elder. Brother Fogg, can you tell us your age?
My age?
Yes. That looks like somewhere around 56. Okay. Give or take about 4 or 5. But let me ask you this, so how many kids do you have? How many kids do you have?
We should go again. Where's Laura?
Got 10? No, you got 2. What's the names? They're twins, right? What are the twins' names? Rion and Ryan?
Ryan and Rion.
Mike and Spike.
weren't your kids born on the same day, approximately 1 year apart? How did you manage that?
Oh, well, that's ancient Chinese secret.
Is that right? Was that a plan or did it just happen?
Ancient Chinese secret. I'm not allowed to discuss it.
So in essence, you're saying that you did plan that?
I'm saying I cannot say.
Is that right?
Okay. I cannot say.
Alrighty. Let's see. What is your wife's name? Are you married?
I'm married. 5, 6. Woo! Wife's name is Tanya.
Okay. And what does Tanya do for a living?
She works.
Okay, great, great. That's just dandy. Okay. She works wonders?
Yeah, she works harder than me.
Okay. And what do you do for a living, sir?
I work also.
Is that right?
Yeah.
And what type of work do you do?
I kill bugs.
Okay, right off.
I kill bugs and I squash mice and rats.
You kill bugs. Okay, and what does your wife do?
Tanya is his administrator.
What does she do? Mom. She works with senior citizens.
She hires senior citizens?
Yeah.
Now, my question to you is, how does that, how does those two positions being in such a contrast to each other, how do they work together?
How do they work together?
Yeah.
They both bring money.
Well, there you have it, brother. You can't get any better than
you're
that.
Right.
May the Lord bless you and keep up the good work.
Yeah. Mrs. Y'all not going. Take it off and be comfortable.
Mrs. Fogg. Mrs.
Yeah,
Fogg. Hi there. Listen, you're
we
on the camera. Mrs. Fogg,
yes.
I have a question for you. How many kids do you have?
I have 9 children.
Can you look at the camera, please? Mrs. Fogg, can you look at the camera? Because you're going to be enjoying this tape years from now. You have how many kids?
This is mine.
Nine?
Nine.
Okay.
This is one kid.
And let me ask you this.
This is one kid.
Now, you have nine kids. How many grandchildren do you have?
Two. 13 and a half.
13? 13 and a half.
13 and a half.
Which one is the half?
Mary Lawrence Johnson.
Okay, 13 and a half. Okay. Okay, and by that you mean that she's expecting?
It's two kids. But now I'm sure you know that.
Okay. Well, we must say that for the tape now. Okay, and now.
Are we going to get to see this?
Yes, you'll get to see this. Okay, let me ask you this. What do you hope to be when you grow up?
When I grow up?
Yes.
Well, I've grown as far as I'm going
now. No, you got some more years ahead of you now.
No. Oh, I'd like to go back to school, get my degree, work with the young people, and try to help them and put them on the right track, because it seems like there are so many on the wrong track.
Is that right?
Yes. I'd like to work with the young people.
Okay, that sounds real good. Okay, what is your husband's name?
He's always seen Paul.
Okay, and how long have you been married?
45 years.
Okay. 45 years. My, that's a long time. That's longer than I am old. Okay. And let me ask you this. Where do you attend church?
The Way of the Cross Church of Christ, 9th and D Street, Northwest Washington, D.C.
Northwest or Northeast?
Northeast, I'm sorry.
Okay.
Ladies. 9th and D is the place to be.
Okay.
Hey, all y'all be quiet.
And let me ask you this. Okay. Who are the youngest of your kids? Who's the youngest?
Vanessa Juanita.
Vanessa Juanita?
Yes.
Okay, and that's your youngest daughter. How old is she?
She's 34.
I understand that you have some twins in the family. Is that correct?
Yes, I have two sets of twins.
Is that right?
Two sets.
Okay, and what are their names? Do you remember?
Do I remember? I hope I do. That's the second set. Now, the first set, Julianne Fogg and Julius Wayne Fogg.
Okay. And what's the second set? Are they still around?
Matthew Frederick Fogg.
Please, no middle names, please.
Mark Anthony Fogg.
Freddie, huh?
Freddie.
I didn't know about Freddie.
No middle names, please. You got to correct that. That wasn't right.
Yes, it was the
family.
Okay. And let's say. Okay. And how are your kids doing?
They all well, doing fine. And I must say, all my married children have their own homes. And they're working and doing well and all have beautiful homes. All of my 5 married children.
Are any of them sleeping on park benches?
If they are, I don't know anything about it.
Okay. Well, that's very good. Then apparently what you're telling me then is the Lord has been gracious.
Very good to us. Very good. Yes? Yes, apparently.
Mrs. Fogg, let me ask you this.
Yes.
If you had to do it over again, would you do it different?
Yes, I would. In this respect, I would. I've thought about it since I've raised children, and I look back. I want to wish I had taken more time with them. And that I mean by taking them places, going out with them. Even though my children were close and I was always expecting, but still I'm sorry that I didn't give up something at home and take my kids out and go to the zoo, to parks, more picnics and more ball games and things like that. I didn't do that very much. And neither did my husband. He worked all the time and stayed in church all the time. And we didn't do a lot of taking our children out. But I had friends that would come. My daughter-in-law's mother was a very good friend to me, Mrs. Isabel Ford. And her sisters, all of them would come over, which the one that you locked in the closet and told her she couldn't go home.
Olivia.
That was Olivia. They told Olivia she wasn't going home, she was going to stay over here. And they were so kind and so nice, and they would come and take my children out. They would take them, she'd carry them to the park, they'd carry them downtown and all those things. But I didn't get, as a mother, I spent most of my time raising them here at home, taking care of them, and feeding them, clothing them, and watching over them in the home and praying with them. I did more of that, you know. But if I had to do it again, I would take him out more and go out with him.
Well, Mommy, you know, ladies and gentlemen, the interviewer is Matthew Fogg, and I would just like to say this to Mom. I think you did a great job with us, and as far as the zoo is concerned, I think we got plenty of that.
I have a zoo right here at home.
You got enough animals running around here. The animal came out of all of us, but you did a great job, and that's very nice. Let me ask you this. If you had to do it over again, would you still have the same amount of kids, or would you have more or less?
Knowing if I had the knowledge that I know now, I would have every one of them. I wouldn't miss the one. And I'm sorry that we lost my little Nicky. That's my only hurt when I stop and look back. We lost little Nicky. But I would have every, and I lost my first one, which would have been 7 boys and 4 girls. I had 7 boys and 4 girls, but I lost 2 little boys. And if I had to do it again, I wouldn't want to lose a one.
Okay, that's good. Let me ask you this. Would you like to remain here, or do you want to move someplace else?
In this house? Uh-huh. You mean in this particular house?
In this house.
No, I would like, right, as I'm getting older and my husband getting older, I would like a house with everything on one floor and a basement. That's what I would like. Because steps on my legs, it's very hard on me to keep climbing steps. I would like to have a house where there are all the rooms on one floor and a basement, if I had my preference.
Okay, well, if I tell you that you will have that within a year, would you believe that?
Yes,